Have you ever wondered why you sweat when you're hot or shiver when you're cold? Or why your cheeks become intensely red and warm when you see a pretty girl or a handsome boy? Have you ever wondered how it is that you continue breathing when you're sleeping? Questions about the uncontrolled actions of our body have plagued medical researchers for centuries, and after ages of research, we today know that majority of our unconscious acts are as a result of the autonomic nervous system. In this video, we will try to explain the structure and the function of the autonomic nervous system. The nervous system of our body is divided into the central and the peripheral nervous systems. The peripheral nervous system consists of the autonomic and the somatic nervous system. The autonomic nervous system can be classified in two ways. Based on functionality, the autonomic nervous system can be divided into the sympathetic and the parasympathetic systems. Based on the chemicals released, the autonomic nervous system can be divided into the cholinergic or an adrenergic system. Please understand that the sympathetic and the parasympathetic systems are not the same as the adrenergic and cholinergic systems. Let us first look at the structure of the autonomic nervous system. The autonomic nervous system has a two-neuron structure. There is a preganglionic neuron, which arises from the lateral horn of the spinal cord and synapses with a postganglionic neuron, which in turn leads to the effector organ. The synapse between two neurons occurs at an autonomic ganglia. The sympathetic nerves arise from the lateral horn of the thoracic and the lumbar vertebrae. As a result, the sympathetic outflow is also known as the thoracolumbar outflow. These fibers are the preganglionic fibers. They go on and synapse with the postganglionic fibers in ganglia on either side of the vertebral column, known as the paravertebral ganglia. A few fibers synapse in ganglia in front of the vertebra, also known as the prevertebral ganglia. Postganglionic fibers travel from the ganglia to the effector organs. The parasympathetic nerves have two outflow tracts from the spinal cord, the cranial and the sacral. As a result, the parasympathetic outflow is also known as the craniosacral outflow. Similar to the sympathetic system, the parasympathetic system has preganglionic and postganglionic fibers leading to and from the ganglia. The ganglia and the cranial outflow are four in number and are associated with the cranial nerves 3, 7, 9, and 10. They regulate the activity of the pupil, the salivary gland, the nasopharyngeal muscles, and some thoracic and abdominal viscerae. The sacral outflow forms a group of nerves known as the nervae erigentes because they cause penile erection and supply other pelvic viscerae. We have so far assumed that all of the autonomic nervous system functions on a two-neuron system. But like any good rule, this one has an exception. The adrenal medulla is a part of the sympathetic nervous system and functions as a modified ganglion. The fibers innervating the adrenal medulla result in the release of adrenaline directly into the blood. There are no postganglionic fibers in this series. Now that we are familiar with the structure of the autonomic nervous system, let us focus on its functions. There are four main functions the autonomic nervous system carries out: vascular and visceral smooth muscle control, control of the exocrine and the endocrine glands, heartbeat, and the energy and metabolism. These functions are mediated by two groups of neurotransmitters, acetylcholine and noradrenaline. This forms the basis of the cholinergic system and the adrenergic system. The cholinergic system has two types of receptors, nicotinic and muscarinic, whereas the adrenergic system also has two types of receptors, alpha and beta. These neurotransmitters are released from the pre- or the postganglionic neurons and attach onto their respective receptors to cause appropriate effects. When their work is done, they are degraded by enzymes or are taken back up into the axon, hence terminating their actions. Now, there are three rules of the neurotransmitters that must be remembered. Rule number one: parasympathetic postganglionic fibers are cholinergic and act through muscarinic receptors. Rule number two: sympathetic postganglionic fibers are adrenergic and act through alpha or beta receptors. The exception is the sweat gland, which is innervated by the sympathetic postganglionic fibers, which are cholinergic in nature. And rule number three: all motor nerves act through the cholinergic system using the nicotinic receptors. The sympathetic part of the autonomic nervous system deals with the fight or flight response of the body, whereas the parasympathetic part deals with the rest and digest conditions. The details of the effector mechanisms and their pharmacological implications will be dealt with in our next video. Hope you like this video, and be sure to check out our previous video, which deals with the reflex pathways of the eye and its anomalies. To get regular updates, like us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel.